The weekend is here, and you HTC Vivid users have something to be excited about. What's going on, guys? I'm Aaron from PhoneDog.com, and let's take a look at Ice Cream Sandwich on the HTC Vivid. AT&T HTC Vivid users, it's Friday, and you've got a little treat to celebrate the weekend with. The Ice Cream Sandwich update is finally available for the HTC Vivid on AT&T. If you haven't gotten it yet, download it now. Go over to All Apps, hit Updates, and check and see if it's available for your device. But it is rolling out right now to the Vivid. It's available, to my knowledge, to all Vivid users. They're not rolling it out in phases, so you should be able to get it right now. Now, out of the box, it looks pretty similar. You're going to notice things like the carousel notifications here and Sense as a whole, but there are some upgrades. It's obviously Android 4.0 now, but it's running HTC Sense version 3.6. And immediately out of the gate, you're going to notice some changes. For example, down here, you'll see the dock is different. You're going to see when you go to the menu that you've got a nice kind of gray and black color scheme here. Quick settings looks different, as you can tell. And I wish I had an older Sense device on me right now on my desk, but I don't. So you can see the network ID as well. And then, of course, your recently used applications. But you're going to see things like that. For example, when you hit menu, because you do have capacitive buttons on these older Android devices, you'll see that it comes up in the Ice Cream Sandwich color scheme with the ability to personalize, add wallpaper, or change the settings. Now, down here, this is particularly cool. We'll jump right into some of the features. These are individual shortcuts, but what you can do is, for example, I can hit mail, and you'll see up top here, edit and remove. That's new to Sense 3.6. And then I can bring mail down here and create a folder. Sorry about that. Create a folder. So when I come over here, I can rename the folder. Let's just say mail accounts, for example. And I can hit that when I'm done. I can come in here and it says mail accounts, and it brings up Gmail and mail. Sorry for that focus issue just now, but mail and Gmail. So whenever I open it up, I can say, well, I can go to my mail account or I can go to my Gmail account, and I have those easy access. Now, you can customize those how you want to. You can bring down calendar if you wanted to with messages, for example, and you can really make this your own. So HTC is taking that personalization and customization thing to a whole new level here. Now, otherwise, like I said, menu interface has changed, or notification bar interface has changed, rather, with your quick settings, and you've got a shortcut to Wi-Fi settings and your additional settings down through here. But let's just walk through all apps and take a look. Again, you're going to see the font change immediately. Still kind of the same setup here with the applications scrolling down instead of sideways like we saw in Sense 4.0, or Sense 4 rather. Don't let them hear you call it Sense 4.0. But Sense 4 at Mobile World Congress, you know, we saw the apps kind of going sideways, kind of like TouchWiz version 4.0. Here, they still scroll up and still scroll down, but you'll see the font difference, and then again, you'll see frequent and downloaded down here, just like you've seen on past HTC Sense, I'd say version 3.0 and up, if I recall, but I could be wrong there. Don't hold me to that. Settings here, and it's grouped an Ice Cream Sandwich factor, or form factor rather, by wireless and networks devices. Got personal, and then system as well. Now, this update to the HTC Vivid brings Beats audio integration, so you can see out of the box here, and it's grayed out. But it says sound enhancer is not available for speaker out, but I've got the off and on switch there. And then over here, I've got Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, mobile network, that usage meter that a lot of people really like, and Ice Cream Sandwich is available on this device now, and then more. And when I hit more, it brings up all my different wireless network settings here as well. Down here, personalize, and you can see some slight changes. Again, comparing this to Sense 4 that we saw at Mobile World Congress, there are some differences here within the actual menu interface and some other minor things, which we'll talk about when we get some of those devices in the office. But you can see your personal and then system as well down through here, and about phone. So we'll go over here and take a look just so I can prove to you. Software information, HTC Sense 3.6, Android version 4.0.3. Now bear with me here while I pull this out and make sure I haven't called anybody or doing any testing. No, I haven't done anything major. I've got a little demo phone number in there, but you can see some differences here as well. And if you're a true HTC Sense user and you're a true Sense user on AT&T, you're going to immediately notice that these numbers look ever so slightly different. And then you're going to see things like and PhoneDog Aaron will do this demo phone, for example, and you can see that this looks a little bit different down here at the bottom, and just some minor changes. So again, a lot of it's aesthetic change. You see some font changes. You see some minor changes with borders and with things like that. Otherwise, very similar. You'll see the Google search bar is different as well. You've got the Ice Cream Sandwich search bar, and then you have the ability to hit the sound and use your voice actions out of the gate. You notice similar changes in some of the applications as well if you've worked with Ice Cream Sandwich on the Galaxy Nexus or some of the other, the few devices at that, but still the few devices that have got Ice Cream Sandwich. Go in here to All Apps, for example, and take a look at Maps. Actually, I thought I had a shortcut. I think I do. Yeah, Maps out here. And you can see updated for Ice Cream Sandwich. You can see the form factor is a little bit different here. You got search, your directions, places, and then, of course, you can add things like traffic, terrain, satellite, and more. And again, take a look. You know, that blue font with those buttons at the bottom, symbolic of Ice Cream Sandwich, and then the ability to come down here and do your stuff like check in, join latitude, and more. Same thing with Gmail. Let's go ahead and take a look at that. And you can see the Gmail interface has been updated as well with the shortcut buttons at the bottom. And then when I go into, let's say, Google Play, for example, I can scroll right up and it leaves a header at the top so I always know who I'm emailing and who I'm responding to. And I can scroll back and forth between the emails pretty quickly and pretty easily. So nice change there as well. So all in all, it looks good on the HTC Vivid. A lot of differences here. The one that's big for me is whenever I hit the menu button, I still can't get you. I'm used to the big buttons popping up in the bottom. I'm not used to the whole kind of customized and changed interface here that we've seen on some of the other ice cream sandwich devices. And I think that's because there are no on-screen buttons. The physical buttons kind of throw you off and make you think, oh, gingerbread, big buttons at the bottom. Not the case here. And same thing with the browser. We'll go ahead and take a look at the internet just so you can see what it looks like. Same setup here as previous versions of Sense. But then when I hit the menu, you can see again a lot of differences there. One thing it did add before we sign off, and this I thought was pretty cool, in addition to Notes and some other little programs out of the gate, you have developer options as well. And you can come in here and do USB debugging, you can do some user interface changes, some apps, you can change your, window animation scale, you can do things like USB debugging, you can come down here and show screen updates, show CPU usage, and more. So it's a nice update. It's available now. It brings you up to Sense 3.6 and Ice Cream Sandwich Android 4.0. Much more coverage to come on PhoneDog.com with the Vivid and with Ice Cream Sandwich, and heck, even with Sense 3.6 on the site. So keep it locked. Like us on Facebook, facebook.com/PhoneDog. And if you've gotten this update and you're super happy with your HTC Vivid now, be sure to leave a review and let us know what you think. PhoneDog.com/rankings. Vote on your phone. Take it to the top in our user-generated PhoneDog rankings program, at PhoneDog.com/rankings. Follow me on Twitter as well, PhoneDog_Aaron, and let me know what you think of the update. Thanks, and as always, have a great weekend.